adding integers with different signs. Please make sure that you write everything in your notes that is in this video because it is all important and good to know. To add numbers or integers with different signs, you're actually going to subtract the integers, subtract the numbers, and take the sign of the number with the greater absolute value. This means that the sum is positive if the absolute value of the positive integer is greater. Let's look at some examples. Here's the first one. Negative 32 plus 40. We have two integers with different signs, one negative and one positive. In order to solve this problem, we're going to subtract the numbers and take the sign of the number with the greater absolute value. I'm going to do my work over here in the side with the white space. The absolute value of negative 32 is 32 because it is 32 spaces or units away from zero. The absolute value of 40 is 40 because it is 40 units away from zero. So to solve this problem, I'm going to subtract 40 minus 32, and that gives me 8. Now, the larger with the number, I said that backwards, the number with the larger, there we go, absolute value is 40. And 40 was positive. When we look at our problem, it was positive 40, which means that our sum is going to be positive. So this 8 that I got right here is going to be positive. That means negative 32 plus 40 equals positive 8. Let's try another example. In our second example, we have negative 5 plus positive 4 plus positive 3. There are three integers here. Two of them have a positive sign and one is negative. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to combine my positive integers first. So I'm going to bring that negative 5 down. I haven't done anything with it yet. And I know that positive 4 plus positive 3 is going to be a positive 7. So I have negative 5 plus positive 7. I'm going to go ahead and find the absolute value of negative 5, and that is 5. And the absolute value of 7 is 7. The number with the larger absolute value is positive 7, because positive 7 has an absolute value of 7, which is greater than 5. So my answer is going to be positive. Now remember, we subtract the numbers, 7 minus 5, and we'll get 2. And my answer is going to be positive because 7 was the number with the greatest absolute value and it was also positive. So negative 5 plus 4 plus 3 is going to equal 2. We could also represent this problem using a model for those of you who are like me and are visual learners. So look in the white space to the right. In that space, I have drawn 5 negative signs within some circles. So 5 little objects, these represent the negative 5 in our problem. I added 4 green circles with plus signs inside of them to represent the positive 4. And I also drew 3 green circles with plus signs in those to represent the positive 3. And what I can do is I can cancel them out. This is something we call zero pairs. 1 positive plus 1 negative equals 0, so that can be canceled out. And we can keep doing this until we can't cancel any more out. Now, this negative can be mixed with 1 positive to create a zero pair and cancel out. And what we're left with right here is 2 positives, which happens to be our answer to that problem. We will practice this more in class. Well, what happens if the absolute value of the negative integer is greater? In that case, the sum is negative if the absolute value of the negative integer is greater. An example of this would be negative 15 plus positive 10. Remember, what we do to solve a problem like this is we subtract the numbers and take the sign of the number with the greater absolute value. So I'm going to say 15 minus 10, and 15 minus 10 gives me 5. Now to figure out whether or not that answer is negative or positive, I need to look at the absolute values of my numbers. The absolute value of negative 15 is 15, and the absolute value of 10 is 10. Negative 15 in this case has the greater absolute value. And because negative 15 is negative, then the sum of negative 15 plus positive 10 is going to be a negative number. So up here, when I said 15 minus 10, I subtracted the numbers. Now what I need to do is take the sign of the number with the greater absolute value, and that was negative 15. So my answer for negative 15 plus positive 10 is negative 5. Let's look at one final example. Positive 5 plus negative 4 plus negative 4. And again, I'm going to do my work in this white space to the right. The easiest thing to do is to combine the two integers with the same sign first. So since I'm not doing anything with that 5, I'm just going to write it like it is, 5 plus whatever negative 4 plus negative 4 equals. Now remember, when we learned about adding integers with the same sign, we find the sum and then we keep that same sign. So 4 plus 4 gives me 8, but since they're both negative, it's negative 8. So now our problem is positive 5 plus negative 8. What we'll do here is we'll subtract 8 minus 5, and that gives me 3. But what we need to do is we need to take the sign of the number with the greater absolute value. Negative 8 has an absolute value of 8. 5 has an absolute value of 5. Negative 8 has a greater absolute value, and its sign is negative. So I need to have the negative sign in front of my answer, in front of my sum. That means my answer to positive 5 plus negative 4 plus negative 4 is negative 3. Let's view this on a number line to see how it works. In my first problem, 9 plus negative 4, we can show this on the number line by starting at 0, or the origin, and traveling 9 units to the right. So that's positive 9. Now to show the addition of the negative 4, we're going to have to move 4 spaces to the left, which means we're going backwards 4 spaces. So positive 9 plus negative 4 brings us right above the positive 5, and that is our answer. Let's try it with the negative 9 plus positive 4. Well, for negative 9, I'm going to start at 0, or the origin, and I will have to move to the left 9 units. Now I want to add positive 4. So if I'm adding 4, positive 4, I'm going to go to the right 4 units. Negative 9 plus positive 4 took me to negative 5. So my answer, negative 9 plus positive 4 equals negative 5. Go ahead and determine positive 5 plus negative 3 on your own. You do not have to use a number line, but you can if you would like. Pause the video while you solve and then turn the video back on to check your answer. Positive 5 plus negative 3 can be rewritten as 5 minus 3. Because remember, when you add two integers with different signs, you subtract and keep the number of the sign with the larger absolute value. 5 minus 3 equals 2. And I know that the absolute value of 5 is greater than the absolute value of negative 3, because the absolute value of 5 is 5, and the absolute value of negative 3 is 3. Because the absolute value of this integer right here is larger, and it's positive, then our answer will also be positive. So 5 plus negative 3 equals positive 2. Why don't you go ahead and try this one on your own? Pause the video and then press play to check your answer. The first thing I'm going to want to do with this problem is to combine these two integers that have the same sign, that negative sign. So I can rewrite my problem as 2 plus negative 17, because negative 15 plus negative 2 is negative 17. Now I can write this as a subtraction problem. 17 minus 2, and that's going to give me 15. And the sum of those two numbers, 2 plus negative 17, is going to be dependent on the sign of the number with a greater absolute value. So I know my answer is 15, but I don't know if it's positive or negative yet. What I need to do is find the absolute value of 2 and the absolute value of negative 17. The absolute value of negative 17 is greater than the absolute value of 2. And in my problem, negative 17 is a negative number, which means that my sum will also be a negative number or a negative integer. So 2 plus negative 17 is going to equal negative 15.